We have officially hit the halfway point of the year. This is a really, really beautiful time to have a moment of reflection, to look back on how the year has been so far, what is going well, what's working, what isn't, you know, what we might want to shift and change, to release what no longer serves you, to decide who you want to be moving forward, what version of yourself will actually bring you the most joy and the most authentic fulfillment, and to truly step into that, to step into that version of yourself and focus on what will actually make you happy in the most genuine way moving into the second half of the year. Welcome or welcome back. My name is Danielle, if you are new here. And on this channel, we talk all things personal development, spirituality, and so much more, health, wellness, really going into, digging into all aspects of our well-being, of our holistic health. So in today's video, we are doing a mid-year reset and reflection, almost like a little bit of a life audit, really gaining clarity on what we can do moving forward. One quick thing that I want to say here is that these steps, these five steps, please don't feel like you need to do this all at once. If so, it could become a little bit overwhelming. So something that you could even consider is to break these steps into days and, you know, do this over the course of the next week. Maybe step one is on one day and step two is on the second day. If you want to do it all in one day, by all means, go for it. But don't overwhelm yourself. Sometimes when we get into these planning and reflecting modes, if we go too hard all at once, it can actually become a little bit overwhelming and almost have the opposite effect and then not serve us in the way that it really could. So that is just my little two cents there, is allow yourself as much time and space as you need. And yeah, maybe give yourself the next week to really focus on this. So step number one is going to be some time for you to really focus on self-reflection. I highly, highly recommend getting out your journal. This could be something that you look back at and reflect on every quarter or every 6 months or every year, you know, whatever works best for you. This is your opportunity to really take inventory of how the past 6 months have been for you. I'm going to put on the screen some journaling prompts that you can use for this self-reflection, and feel free to work with any of these. You don't have to work with all of them. If they don't resonate, don't worry about it. You know, choose the ones that resonate. Let go of the ones that don't. Just go through this list, pick out the ones that really inspire you. Put on some beautiful music, light some candles, get yourself a yummy drink like a tea or a coffee or whatever it is, a glass of wine. And yeah, spend some time journaling about the past 6 months. The next thing that you can do is a practice called the Wheel of Life. And you may have seen this before. I will put a little image up on the screen for you guys, but this is really an all-encompassing wheel of different areas of wellness within your life. So this is kind of covering all of the bases. Just go through each of these categories and really assess, take inventory of where you feel fulfilled. You know, where do you feel safe? Where do you feel secure? Where do you feel content? And if you want to journal about this within each category, that can be really beautiful. You could also just rank it on a scale of 1 to 10 of, you know, how fulfilled and satisfied you feel within each of these areas. But the whole point here is just to have a more holistic view of all aspects of your life and where you are feeling within each of these categories. So what this would cover would be your physical health, your mental health, relationships, your home and environment, career, finances, recreation. So this might include your passions, your hobbies, you know, things that you do to have fun, and also your personal and spiritual growth. And really be radically honest with yourself here, right? You don't need to show this to anyone. No one is judging or evaluating what you have to say. So be honest with yourself about how you truly feel in all of these different areas of your life. Step number two is to choose to embody the version of yourself that you want to become. So this is all about your identity and really, really shifting into that highest version of yourself. And this is not about shaming or saying that there is anything wrong with the current version of you. This is simply about deciding and choosing what version of yourself you are ready to step into. Decide who you want to be moving forward. It's really important to have some clarity around what your most embodied self looks like, because without that clarity, we can't actually take the steps that we might want to take to shift into that next level self. If we don't have any idea what that looks like, then how can we make those choices? So spend some time imagining and getting clear on what this version of yourself looks like that you are ready to step into. Another thing to note here is this doesn't always have to be a new identity. If you look back on past versions of yourself and there is this version where you were so lit up, you were embodying all of the things that you love, all of the things that bring you joy, like think back to that version of yourself. What were you doing? Who were you spending time with? What hobbies or things were you doing throughout the day? What were your thoughts? What were your beliefs? And maybe tap back into that version of yourself. And a really beautiful thing that we can sometimes do when we're thinking about the past version of ourselves is also think about what you loved to do as a child. What are the things that really brought you the most joy when you were younger? Because oftentimes, these are things that we just kind of let fall away. As we get older, we maybe think that, oh, we don't have time for that anymore, it's not important, or who knows, you know, what society or our parents or peers have said, but oftentimes the things that brought you joy when you were younger are things that will still bring you joy now. Tap back into that past version of you, that childlike version of you that was so deeply embodied in joy and lightheartedness like children are, and see if you can bring some of those qualities or some of those activities and hobbies back into your life. Spend some time journaling about this as well. You could write this out as a list of qualities. You could write this out as a day in the life. That's something that I really love to do sometimes, is journaling about a day in the life of this person that I want to embody. Or you could even draw this person, like draw a photo of this ideal version of you if you are more artistic. I am not, but you could draw this out and then maybe have like little arrows pointing to all of the different qualities that you want to embody. That's a really fun activity as well. So take out a journal, write it all out, draw it out, whatever works for you. You know that you have tapped into this really beautiful, embodied, joy-filled version of yourself when you feel excited about it. So keep writing, keep journaling until you feel that excitement, and that is when you know that you have tapped into that version of yourself. Once you've written this list, I highly, highly recommend to actually put it somewhere where you can look at it on a daily basis. And so whether that means having your journal out and available and you can just flip that page open every day and remind yourself of this higher version of you, or maybe you post it up on the wall, or maybe you even like write some of these qualities with, what is it? Not permanent marker, but with like non-permanent marker on your mirror, something like that. But just find a way to have a constant reminder of this version of you and who you are ready to be. And think about that version of you when you make decisions moving forward. This is such a huge piece. If you can get clear and understand the traits, the actions, the decisions of the version of yourself that you want to be, it makes decisions so much easier, because anytime that something comes up, you can just think to yourself, okay, what would that version of me do? And you will know, trust me, you will know. So you can start to make these decisions and these actions and choices based on that most embodied version of yourself. All right, step number three is to take inventory and possibly create new goals or intentions, maybe both, depending on you, and systems and habits. If you already set goals or intentions at the beginning of the year, this is a really beautiful time to really reevaluate and see if these goals or intentions are still working for you. You know, what is working, what isn't. Maybe you've already achieved some of your goals. Maybe they no longer resonate. So this is just a really beautiful time to reevaluate. So what is a goal? A goal is a specific desired outcome or result. You can think of this as a target or destination to work towards. An intention, on the other hand, is a guiding principle or mindset for how you want to be, feel, and show up in the world. And this is really more focused on the present moment and qualities and values that you want to embody. You can think of an intention as a compass, and this compass, this intention, is really pointing you in the direction of who you want to be, so that you know what actions or choices you need to make to get to where you want to go. Now, systems, on the other hand, are the consistent processes, routines, or habits designed to support the achievement of goals or desired outcomes. This is the consistent action that helps you move forward and make big changes, but in a more sustainable way. Now, definitions can be great, but sometimes we need examples to like really be able to break this down in our minds. I know I do. Let's just say, for the purpose of making an easy example, that you have a goal of losing X amount of weight in X amount of time. Now, if you were to look at that and shift it into an intention, then your intention might be something along the lines of prioritizing your overall health and well-being to actually have a healthier relationship with your body, with food, and with exercise. And then from there, you can start to create and implement systems. So some systems here could be a regular exercise routine. You know, maybe you intentionally schedule workouts 3 times per week, or you create a workout split that has, you know, different workouts set up throughout the week, and you know that you are really balancing different types of exercise and really working all of the different muscle groups in your body. You may create a system based on balanced nutrition, so intentionally planning and preparing nutritious meals, doing some meal prep. So those are just some examples of systems that you could actually set up within this goal of losing weight or this intention of healing and having a healthier relationship with your food and with your body and with exercise. Let's say that your goal is to improve your mental health. So maybe you have this goal of being able to meditate for like an hour every single day. So an intention within this goal might be to prioritize mental well-being, develop self-awareness, and foster a sense of inner peace. Some systems that you could set up within this goal, within this intention, would be a daily mindfulness system. So maybe you set aside dedicated time each day for your mindfulness practice, such as meditation, deep breathing exercises, or mindful walking. So now that you have a little bit of a clearer idea of the difference between goals, intentions, and systems, the action step that I would suggest or maybe invite you to take part in is to really break this down for yourself. And if goals don't resonate, focus on intentions, focus on systems, but just find what works best for you and find what is going to really support you in the most nourishing way without stressing you out. You can make this as simple as possible. You could focus on one word, one intention, just like one word that embodies how you want to feel moving forward for the next 6 months. If that is the best way for you to go about this, then do that. I have sometimes done that where at the beginning of the year, I just decide on one word and that is the word that I want to embody for that year. And just by knowing that word, it allows me to make choices and decisions and actions that are really leaning towards what it is that I want to embody. Or if you want to do a little bit more, you could set 1, 2, 3 goals or intentions, but I do not recommend setting any more than 3. When we have too many goals, when we have too many priorities or intentions, we're actually going to lose our focus on all of them. Like when there's too many, there is no focus. It's just too broad. So 1 to 3 goals or intentions that you can really hone in on and give your full attention for the rest of this year. And in terms of the systems and habits, a couple of questions that you can ask yourself here, and again, you could journal about this or you could just think about this, would be what routines, systems, and habits can I implement that will support my goals? What small practical steps can I begin to implement today or this week? So take action on this. Like I said, you can journal out your 1, 2, or 3 intentions or goals for the next 6 months, and then start to create some systems that you can put into place that will really help you and support you towards the attainment of those goals and intentions. And step 4 is to optimize your environment, optimize your space to best support you. Marshall Goldsmith said that if we do not create and control our environment creates and controls us. It is so important that you really optimize your environment for your health, for your mental health, and to make your routines and habits as easy as possible to implement. Clean your home, maybe even clean out your closet. If there are some parts of your home or your house that you have just been putting off cleaning those areas, pick a day, you know, choose a weekend and make now the time, because now is the best time. And honestly, you will feel so much better shifting into all of these other things, implementing these other practices and systems and habits if you have a clean space. Maybe set out objects that will be more supportive for you. If you have a goal or intention to move your body more, to exercise more, you know, can you set out your workout clothing the night before? Can you have your tennis shoes ready to go or your yoga mat ready to go? What are the things that you can do in your space, in your environment, that will make those actions more likely to actually happen? Another thing that you can do within this environmental reset is a digital detox. Hear me out on this one. I know how challenging this can be, but this is something that could make a massive, massive difference for you moving forward. Honestly, social media can be one of the most distracting things that we have in our lives. I know that it is one of the things that is the biggest distraction for me. And social media, you know, technology is also a tool for numbing. What things can we do instead to fill that space, or even just to sit with ourselves in those moments? If we are numbing, why are we numbing? What are we trying to numb? What do we need to touch base with within ourselves? What do we need to look at? Like, that could be a perfect moment for some self-reflection, for some journaling, or a walk in nature, or just different ways to calm the mind. So a social media detox is one of the best things that you can do every once in a while to really reset yourself, reset your mind. Make a list of all of the things that you love or all of the things that you've been wanting to do, but you just haven't had the time. And when you do this social media detox, fit in those things. It's the perfect time to finally dedicate to the things that just haven't fit in to the doom scrolling and, you know, 2 hours getting lost on TikTok. So take action here, clean your space. Again, it doesn't have to all be in one day, but really set aside this time to declutter, take some time to set up your space to best support you and your goals moving forward. Step 5, the final step, is just to have fun with this. This is not meant to be something that causes more stress. If it is causing you more stress, maybe now is not the time. If what you need in this moment is just to rest and relax and practice self-care and just be and not plan or strategize or set up systems, whatever it may be, tap into yourself. honor yourself, nourish yourself. It is not supposed to be stressful. It is actually supposed to be fun and nourishing. So that is really the step here, is to have fun with this. Find ways to bring more joy into your life. Find ways to really practice habits in a way that brings you more joy, that is more playful. You do not have to take life so seriously. I've said this so many times. I feel like I say this in like so many of my videos, but life is not meant to be so serious. I promise you that it does not have to be so serious. Something that can be really fun here, and you can consider this as your action step, is to create a favorite things day, or a day where you simply do all of the things that bring you the most joy. Create something to look forward to. So you can write a list here of all of the things that make you happy, all of the things that bring you the most joy, and literally plan a day based around these things. Schedule it on your calendar. I literally want you to pick out a day. It is going to be your fun day, your favorite thing day, and all you are going to do are the things that light you up, the things that bring you the most joy, whatever that is for you. So those are all of the steps to really reevaluate, hit refresh, reset your life for the next 6 months. Comment below and let me know either your one word intention or maybe one to three of your goals that you have that you're going to implement into the next 6 months. I would love, love, love to hear from you guys, just who you are ready to be, who you are looking to embody. I really hope you found this video helpful. I hope that it has inspired you to do your own little life reset. If you liked this video, if you found it helpful, please do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more content like this. Until next time, I will see you in the next video.